Hey everybody, welcome back to my channel. It is Mama Sila here. Please disregard this mama do, you know. I wanted to do something different on this channel and really get more personal with you all. That's what my ultimate thing was to do when I started this budgeting channel. Let's just go ahead and get right into it, and I hope you enjoy the video. Hey everyone, so we are back and this might be a long one, so go ahead and either pause the video, grab your bullet journal or your coffee or your snack if you're just gonna want to watch this video. But this is my first time, I guess, doing a voiceover, so please don't be so judgmental. It is my first time, but I wanted to do something new for this my video or my channel, like I said earlier in the intro. So in the beginning, I did show you the cover and I actually painted it and it said, "See the beauty in everyday things." I will also at the end show the whole overview of what I did in this video. Right here on the inside of the cover page, I wrote a quote and it's from the Bible. It says, "You may not understand now what I am doing, but someday you will." John 13:7. And this holds a special place in my heart because I am a mama, as most of you know. If you don't, yes, I'm a mom. I'm 22 years old and a college student. And this just really touches my heart because oftentimes we are going through situations and we might not understand why God puts us through certain circumstances or just whatever through life. And sometimes we just have to remind ourselves that everything happens for a reason. So on the right side of the page, I am doing the 2020 yearly monthly overview. And whatever event is coming, I might highlight that is important or might be significant. And honestly, that page is really the hardest page, or I guess the most tiring page, because it's a consistent page of numbers and days, I guess, you have to write out. And so I had to put on some YouTube for me to, I guess, be able to go through doing the 2020 overview. Finally, at last, we are done with the 2020 monthly overview and we are gonna go on to the next page. I did have to erase all the pencil erasing, shaving, whatever you call it, away. And here we are doing the key. The key is basically supposed to help me for any events or I guess occasions or appointments that may be coming up or anything that I have a deadline towards. And this will show me what is what. I pretty much know what everything means, but this is just to help me if I ever forget or need something to look back on.
I didn't know how much, you know, eraser you need when you do bullet journaling, but it's a necessity. Right here on the next page, I am writing out my gratitude log, and what I plan to use here or do here is put down either a word or a verse in the Bible that may touch my heart, and something simple and something that I need to think about. On the next page, I do places to go, and that will just be signifying either states or places I may visit with my son. It also could be like amusement park or a zoo. Right here, I write down best memories of 2020. So right here on both of these pages, I plan to put pictures of things that makes me the most happiest during that time, or things that I could just look back on. Right here, which is the most essential, is goals for the year. I section off these two pages in four different categories: personal, travel, fitness, finances, and I'll, once this, you know, once time goes on, I'll finish it before January, of what I really want to accomplish for 2020. Right here, I just write down birthdays, which was the messiest page I think I've done. And sadly, the recording stopped. I don't know what happened, but I had a savings tracker, and also under that, I did a no spend day. So I'll just put down the dates of when I don't spend money, and I can't wait to see how many days I don't spend money throughout this year. Also, there was some parts that didn't record, but I also had another page where I put books to read, because that is a goal of mine, is to read at least 12 books throughout 2020. I already finished one, so I am on the right track to hopefully read more than 12 books. On the next page of the books, I wrote on my mind, because oftentimes I might need a phone number to write down really quickly or something to jot down. And then after that, I skipped three or four pages, I believe, and started January's spread, I guess. I skipped pages because maybe as the days or months go by, I might want to add something in the beginning of the bullet journal so I can easily access that, I guess, so it doesn't get lost in the other future months that are coming up. Right here, I'm just doing January 2020, and I write out the whole month, and I like to keep it simple because I don't like it to be super chaotic, because it'll make my head chaotic. So I just did a circle with flowers, which I thought was cute. Very simple and minimal. Unfortunately, I had a huge idea of something to put on this page, but I didn't know what I wanted to put, so I just started off with goals, and maybe I'll go ahead and add something for the month as, you know, time goes on, as I said earlier. I just write two simple goals right here that I am wanting to tackle for the month of January. Alright, so now we are coming to an end, where finally I am going to be doing the weekly spread. I am doing January 5th through January 11th on the left side, and then on the right side, I'll be doing January 12th through the 18th. And I apologize, my son is now with me, but I am going to write whatever things I have going on for the certain days that are up here. And I'll also be tracking my habits for the week. And so far, I think I've been doing pretty well. and that's when I knew I messed up. So I tried to use this as a highlighter, but it didn't work out. So on the right side, I did not do this. So here is the final product. I really hope you enjoyed this video, and if you have any feedback or anything you think I should add, please go ahead and feel free to leave a comment down below, and I'll love to get back to you. But again, thank you so much for watching my video. Bye everyone.